Everyone, please be seated. I just found here. I'm not sure I got anything left here. It's bad enough to have it be last Sunday, but to have to preach as well is cruel about it, you know. Anyway, some of these are my last words in touch Sunday. It was Margaret Mead who once talked about evolutionary clusters. She was a remarkable anthropologist who studied small groups of people and also studied the reaction of others and how what those people believed spread throughout the world. She was particularly impressed with the American Revolution, with the revolutionaries who studied Rousseau and Locke, a small group of cluster that came together that transformed America and continues to transform the world with our Constitution, our Bill of Rights, our understanding of citizenship. This all started by a small group of people. She said, never doubt the impact of a small group of thoughtful and committed people to change the world. In our Matthew passages now and over the past few weeks, Jesus is setting the scene, if you will, setting the table for a community of Christians that will remain after his death and resurrection. In that group of 12, never doubt that a small group can change the world, because that group of 12 became 300, became 3,000 on the day of Pentecost. Think where we would be now if those brave men and women didn't commit themselves to doing what Christ wanted them to do, to transform their lives, to transform the world in the image of God. These days, we have a lot of our friends and family, actually, who believe that you can be spiritual or religious without being a member of a community or a church. But those of you who are here know how effective, how amazing it is to join into a community, to risk that. And it is a risk, because when two or more are gathered in a community, there are two or more humans as well. People who might disagree with each other, people who might have differences of opinions, people who might be sitting in your pew, people who might be voting differently than you are, people who on a Sunday afternoon might be rooting for one team or another, people you may not like. That's the risk that happens when we gather together. 35 years ago, I moved into a church rectory. And apparently the former rector had two obsessions. One was that he liked to collect old radiators. And the other was that he liked to collect and tumble stones. There were rocks everywhere in this house. He apparently liked to shine up stones. You put them in this tumble, and they shine up. They become smoother. That's what happens in a Christian community. When we gather together, we bring our rough edges, if you will, our insecurities, our baggage, our emotional stuff, our whatever, to here, and together we kind of jumble around in that old barrel, and then we kind of spit out the smoother edges, the shiny things that become what is St. Margaret's. Because this community is such, When we gather together, we are risking that we might end up in a pew with someone else who we may not know or may know too well. And yet, when we pass the peace, we become one. We become united. And together, we leave here in this jumble smoother and shinier. Because Christians have a special responsibility to be the grown-ups in the room. We have to be adults. We are the ones who reach out to those that we do not like and say, let's talk here. One of the things I don't like about that reading in Matthew is it seems to be all about the person who seems to have done the wrong. What about your part in it? What about that? Because as Christians, we have to open our heart to be transformed and changed, as well as those who seem to have wronged us. Because righteous anger is not something we can afford to do. Because as Christians, we have to stand up and reach across the aisles, give hugs where we don't want to hug, and yet we are Christians, and this is who we are. When I came to St. Margaret's, I was one of those rough rocks, we'll put it. It's funny because I'm going to the Granite State. I mean, it's like, you know, I was thinking about this metaphor and I'm thinking, oh, right, okay, well, all right, I'm going to the Granite State. I was known as a flinty one. I was known as, as I've said before, my son, when I was ordained, he said, Mom, you're going to have to be nice to people. When you are in a loving community, how easy it is to allow your heart to be opened, to be smoothed, to let other people encourage you to shine, to watch other people as they shine, to encourage people to join in that great barrel of rough stones in order to be transformed, in order to transform the world. Because St. Margaret's is known as the church that is awesome. How many of you have said, well, I go to St. Margaret's, and people have said, oh, I've heard really great things about that church. And you stand up a little taller and say, yeah, great things are happening at this church. Because together, we have opened our hearts to change, and together we will change the world. Never doubt that that is what St. Margaret's is here for, is to be that transformative spirit, to be the ones that overcome differences in this world, because Lord knows this world needs people like us to say, yes, we disagree. As they say, I may not like you, but I love you. To be able to say, yeah, we share something very special, and that is Christ's love. It's very amazing that on this Sunday, we will be handing out an amazing booklet, which is called Be Transformed. In it are all the different ways that St. Margaret's opens the opportunity to be transformed and also to transform the world. Thank you, Mom. So thank you. Thank you for transforming me. Some of you are surprised to know that I really was a baby priest when I came. That I never had a full-time ministry before. I didn't know if I could do it. And I'm leaving here knowing I can do it. The problem is that I have to leave you here. I can't take you with me to help me in the next place, because you guys have helped me. You've shined me, you've polished me, and I hope that I've helped you do that as well for each other. It's been remarkable, and I say thank you. Amen. Yes.